This is Liz from Homegirl and Homestead. This is artisan bread today, and it's kind of all that's going to be in this video because I'm going to show the process from beginning to end. I'm not really going to cut a whole lot out other than maybe speed it up. I used to make this artisan bread in my other house when we lived in the city, and it worked out great. But then all of a sudden it started not rising, and I couldn't tell if it was I didn't have my water warm enough or my yeast was getting old or anything like that. So I just kept trying, and then all of a sudden there'd be a good one. And when we moved then out where we are now, I found my bread machine. So I figured, well, I'm just gonna switch to using the bread machine, which was great and it tastes good and we love it and all. And I found a recipe that Russ likes, but he also really likes the artisan bread. So I haven't tried it yet. We've been in this house 2 years now, and I'm going to try it because my kitchen situation is a little different. My kitchen gets a lot warmer. It just is. There's only one little window in my kitchen, so when I bake or have the oven on, I should say, it just isn't baking. It gets really hot in there. So I thought I'd try my hand at it one more time. Now, as you see this, I started stirring, and I usually do it with my hand, but for the video, I figured, well, I probably shouldn't. But I think I might go back to using my bare hand, because going back to the basics, my grandmother taught me how to make good old bread, and everything was based on touch. You could tell when it needed more flour or it needed more water. Well, as you can see here, as I'm starting to stir this up, yep, you add the water in a little bit at a time. But then I ended up just pouring in the rest of the water, and I shouldn't have. I knew better, and I knew the minute I did it, I thought, oh no. But I thought, okay, let's try it. Let's see what happens. So this bread I let rise for 18 hours. It's one of those that can go from 12 to 24. So you'll see here how it gets real liquidy. So it was all nice and bubbly and everything, and then as I started getting out of the bowl, yeah, it's still way too liquidy. Could I have let it rose even more? Probably, but then it's just going to happen again. So this is where I figured, well, I'm not going to, you know, throw all this away, just going to add more flour. And now you'll see the process of just adding more flour and working that in, where artisan bread, you don't need the bread, so it's kind of like I'm not wrecking it, but it will make a little difference. It didn't get all nice and tall for me like I usually like, but it worked out. So here, as I let it sit and kind of rest, which it is resting, this is where you turn the oven on. Now, most of the time, I usually heat up the lid at the same time, but this recipe said don't. I think I'll go back to having it on when I heat up my Dutch oven. Now I'm going to put it in there. I always do put it on the parchment paper. Yes, there is enamel coating, but I just like the way I can pop it right out. So I checked it a little by tapping on it. If it doesn't sound hollow, I just put it right back in. But it sounded pretty good, nice hard top. When I pull this out of the Dutch oven, you'll see it isn't very tall. But then again, not a lot of artisan breads are. So it tasted wonderful. It was great. And actually, you'll see in another video where I had a couple slices left over in the end and I made croutons out of them. Oh boy, that was delicious too. So now I'm just going to let it cool, and then I'm going to do a little bit more cleaning here, and let's clean up after the mess I kind of made in the kitchen. Thank you for watching, everybody. I will see you in the next video, and I really hope you enjoy your day, even in this heat. Gotta find some way to cool yourself off and just enjoy yourself. Bye!